is a bit of a transition day, so we've moved the rain on out, but our winds are out of the north and west. We're going to have a cooler afternoon overall, but we should see skies brightening up enough to dry things out as well, and we won't see any more rain for at least a couple more days. Satellite radar, we're looking good. We do still have some clouds in the area, and as we head through the day, we're going to see a mix of sun and clouds into the afternoon. The rainfall that moved through yesterday was heaviest to the north, which is what we were expecting, and Lafayette picked up over an inch of rain. Indianapolis, 0.16 inches of rainfall, and lighter to the south. But Indianapolis to date, we are the seventh wettest April on record, and before the month is out, we'll be picking up more rain to add on to those totals. We'll see where we end up. We have a little bit of fog out there this morning, primarily off to our south and east, where we're seeing over Shelby County, Shelbyville. That visibility is reduced to about a third of a mile. Traveling down into Jackson and Lawrence County, visibility also looking a little bit more reduced. So just be aware that as you're driving along, you might encounter some fog as you're heading on out. 46 is where we are in Indy, 48 in Muncie, and 50 in Batesville. So these temperatures are cool. Certainly not too bad for this morning, but you need the jacket. And on into the afternoon, we're not going to warm up all that much. We'll be about 10 degrees below average for this time of year. At noon, we'll be into the lower 50s, and to the late afternoon, temperatures in the upper 50s, looking for a high right around 57 degrees, but we should see those skies brighten. Tree pollen today at high levels, mold at medium high levels, and then on into the evening hours, we'll see mostly clear skies and temperatures by 9 o'clock, lower 50s. Tomorrow morning, we will be even colder. We'll see temperatures fall into the mid 30s. We have the chance to see some patchy frost developing tomorrow morning, so that's something to be on the lookout for. If you have any sensitive plants that have started blooming, you'll want to find ways to either cover them up or bring them indoors if you can. But as we get into Thursday afternoon, we're going to see temperatures warming into the 60s. That's still going to be below average for this time of year, lower 60s. We should be in the upper 60s, but sunshine and an improvement, and we'll just continue to warm temperatures from there. As we get into Friday, we'll be near or into the lower 70s, but Friday is our next chance of rain, primarily into the afternoon and evening hours. Some scattered showers, a few thunderstorms will be possible. Then we'll have some off and on showers as we head into the coming days. We'll find dry time over the weekend, but you'll have to plan it around some showers. So for Saturday, the showers primarily in the morning, but it wouldn't rule out a few spotty showers continuing into the afternoon and evening. And then on Sunday, primarily a dry day, rain coming in late, and then moving in as we get into Monday. Monday is looking to be a rather wet day for us. 57 for a high today, up to 61 tomorrow, and 60 I do think some will get into the low 70s on Friday, but then we're near 80 on Saturday and into the 80s on Sunday. We'll keep the milder temperatures around as we head into next week too.